After doing the current distribution, which point is the higher potential point, which point is the lower potential point. Now, negative terminal is taken as lower potential point, positive terminal is taken as higher potential point. Negative terminal is taken as lower potential point, positive terminal is taken as higher potential point. Now, negative terminal is taken as lower potential point, positive terminal is taken as higher potential point. Now, current is traveling like this. This is called higher potential point. Now, this is called lower potential point. Now, current is traveling. Therefore, this is called lower potential point. Now, this is called higher potential point. Here, that is, this is E1 and this is E2. Here, across the resistance R1, what is the potential difference? I2 R1. Right, across the resistance R2, what is the potential difference? I3 and R2. Now choose any one of the loop. Let us consider. I will consider A, B, D, C, A. Now this is called arbitrary loop. A, B, D, C, A. This is called, what to say? Arbitrary direction. Right? While moving through the arbitrary direction, don't consider the current direction. We may go in the direction of current. Right? We may go opposite to the direction of the current. Therefore, choose A, B, C, D, A. Initial point must be coincides with the final point. Thereby, we can take the closed loop. In this closed loop, A, B, D, C, A. This is a closed loop. How many cells are there? E1 and E2. This is called E1 and E2. How many resistors are there? Only one resistance. How many branches are there? Only one branch. What is the potential difference? That is I2 into R1. Therefore, I2 into R1. According to Kirchhoff's second law, the algebraic sum of this one is equals to 0. Now, what is my arbitrary direction? A, B, C, right? A, B, D, C, A. A, B, D, C, A. This is my arbitrary direction. Right? This is like this. A. Right? Higher to lower. I am traveling higher to lower. Higher to lower means drop. Drop is taken as negative. Next, I am traveling lower to higher. I am traveling lower to higher. Lower to higher is taken as positive. Therefore, this is called positive. Next, continuously, here in this case, higher to lower. Therefore, continue the arbitrary direction, higher to lower. Higher to lower is taken as a drop. Therefore, this is the negative symbol. Rise is taken as positive, drop is taken as negative. What is my loop? This is my loop. A, B, D, C, A is the loop. Right? Loop is itself considered as a arbitrary direction. Right? I want to move along the arbitrary direction. What is my arbitrary direction? A, B, D, C, A. Just move along the arbitrary direction. Don't consider the current direction. Therefore, as I am moving higher to lower, therefore, here drop is there, there is a negative symbol. As I am moving lower to higher, there is a potential rise is there, therefore it is called positive term. As I continue to travel, right, higher to lower, again it is taken as a drop. The drop is taken as, what to say, negative I2 into R1. That is I2 into R1. Right, next. Therefore, for this particular loop, what is the Kirchhoff second law equation? This is the Kirchhoff second law. Or you may write like this also. R, that is E1 minus E2 plus I2 into R1 is equals to 0. Right, you may take another loop also. You may take another loop. C, D, F, E, C. Therefore, C, D, F, E, what to say? C. C, D, F, E, C. This is my particular loop. C, D, F, BIPC. This is my particular loop. This particular loop is also considered as a arbitrary direction. I want to travel along the arbitrary direction. Now, in this particular loop, how many cells are there? Only one cell is there. That is, what to say, E3 is there. In this particular loop, how many resistors are there? Two resistors are there. Right? Two resistors means two branches are there. Two branches means that is two products of currents and resistances. Right? One product of current and resistance, I2, R1. Next product of current and resistance, I3 and R2. Here in this case, the product of current and resistance, that is I2 into R1. The product of current and resistance, I3 and R2, I3 and R2 is equals to 0. Therefore, here in this case, according to the arbitrary direction, C, D, F, E, C. Now, right, arbitrary direction, as I am moving like this, as I am moving like this, lower to higher. As I am moving like this, lower to higher. Lower to higher is taken as a drop. Therefore, drop is taken as negative. Therefore, I2 R1 is negative. Next, as I continue to travel, therefore this is higher and lower. As I continue to travel, higher to lower. As I continue to travel, higher to lower. As I continue to travel, higher to lower. Higher to lower drop. Drop is taken as, what to say, negative. Therefore this is the negative. Next, as I continue to travel through the resistor R2, lower to higher, therefore it is taken as positive drop, rise. Now here in this case, this is my particular loop, this is the particular loop. In this particular loop, how many cells are there? E3. Next, how many resistors are there? R1 and R2. How many branches are there? Two branches. How many products of current and resistances? Current multiplied by resistance. Current multiplied by resistance. Here current multiplied by resistance, I2 R1. Current multiplied by resistance, I3 R2. Now, if I go through my arbitrary direction like this, here I am traveling lower to higher. It is taken as a drop. Drop is taken as negative. Therefore, there is a negative symbol. As I continue to travel, higher to lower, it is taken as rise. Rise is taken as positive. Therefore, rise is taken as, what to say, positive E3. Next, if I continue to travel lower to higher is taken as, what to say, rise. Right? That is, rise is taken as positive. Right? This is the application.